Massive leak just exposed what Trump is about to do to North Korea. Kim Jong Un has done the acrimony between North Korea and the United States as well as the rest of the Western world has been increasing as of late. All thanks to the Kim regime's testing of intercontinental ballistic missiles, which are clear violations of United Nations as well as international laws. President Trump has not taken kindly to Kim Jong Un's threats of nuclear war, and he has prepared us for the worst possible scenario. A leak from the deep state has indicated that the president has prepared the United States and our military branches for a nuclear strike against our Korean enemy within at least a year. This is mere days after North Korea announced their so-called successful practice launch of a ballistic missile which is reportedly strong enough to hit and destroy the United States mainland. Anonymous sources within the senior level of the military have told reporters with the Mail in Washington, D.C. that officials within the Pentagon have put forth extremely elaborate plans for nuclear warfare and the creation of a facility that operates deep within the mountains for a rogue state. If this information becomes public knowledge and is, in fact, true, then the United States could be on the verge of war with North Korea, especially considering North Korea's development of nuclear weapons. This latest development came as a result of learning that the North Korean ballistic missile had a range of 6,500 miles. Nuclear policy experts were greatly concerned after this latest test because this latest missile is projected to be able to hit large cities in the United States such as Los Angeles, California, Denver, Colorado, Chicago, Illinois, Boston, Massachusetts, as well as New York City, New York. However, Kim Jong Un said he could hit any city at any time. Whether that is true or not remains to be seen. In retaliation for the ballistic missile practice launch, the United States held B-1 bomber drills near the Korean Peninsula as well as began live fire exercises, which is in line with what the president said was taking all the necessary steps to ensure the security of American allies and the United States. These latest actions indicate what the president plans to do in the future. At a full cabinet meeting, the president said the following: "We will handle North Korea. We are gonna be able to handle them. It will be handled. We handle everything." In a series of tweets on social media, the president indicated he was not pleased with China's lack of help in holding North Korea accountable and maintained that he felt North Korea's neighbor and greatest ally could have done more. He said, "I am very disappointed in China. Our foolish past leaders have allowed them to make hundreds of billions of dollars a year in trade, yet they do nothing for us with North Korea, just talk. We will no longer allow this to continue. China could easily solve this problem." Japan's Prime Minister Shinzo Abe has responded to the latest nuclear missile test as well, stood behind President Trump when he said, "We have made consistent efforts to resolve the North Korean problem in a peaceful manner, but North Korea has ignored that entirely and escalated the situation in a one-sided way. The international community, starting with China and Russia, must take this obvious fact seriously and increase pressure." The United States United Nations Ambassador Nikki Haley, who was formerly a politician from the Carolinas, said the following about this latest nuclear attack: "The time for talk is over. The danger the North Korean regime poses to international peace is now clear to all." In another statement, she said, "An additional Security Council resolution that does not significantly increase the international pressure on North Korea is of no value."
It sends the message to the North Korean dictator that the international community is unwilling to seriously challenge him. China must decide whether it is finally willing to take this vital step. If anything were to happen in the Korean Peninsula, the United States is in the best possible position it could be. We have allies in Japan as well as South Korea and Australia, which is not that far away. While the doors of communication have been open between Chinese officials and the Trump administration, the most concerning point of this all is that we are only aware because someone leaked this information about the president's plans to combat North Korea to the public. This is a major national security concern to have people with high-level security clearance sharing this type of classified information to the public. We are not safe if the president's plan is released because it gives North Korea the chance to try and adjust their nuclear and military policy to combat us. Instead of trying to tear the president down, what these leakers should do is work their rear ends off to try and ensure that North Korea never has the chance to even get near our borders, let alone try and send a missile our way.